Hello and welcome, friends. You're watching Math for Juniors. I'm Miss Marks and this is Snail, my assistant, always eating, huh?
So, what are we going to learn today, Miss Marks?
Well, Snail, we are going to learn about quadrilaterals today. The top face of this cake, this bread slice, or even this barfi, walls of this room, floor, even this blackboard, they are all quadrilaterals.
Quadrilaterals are so yummy. I sure must dig into them.
If you want to dig into them, let's zoom into the world of math. You must have heard of the word quadrilateral. Ever wondered what it means? Well, quad means four and lateral means sides. So the word quadrilateral translates to four sides. To elaborate, a quadrilateral is a plain mathematical figure with four sides and four angles. A quadrilateral is named by taking the vertices in order, either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction. The line segments that join the opposite vertices of a quadrilateral are called its diagonals. The sum of the four angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. Quick, Snail, help me measure the angles of this board here and I will let you eat the barfi.
This angle is 30 degrees plus this one too plus 150 plus 150 degrees. So this becomes 360 degrees.
There you go. You can eat the barfi now. So much motivation a barfi can provide.
Food is always motivating.
Now, Snail, like I said before, quadrilaterals can be classified further. Let's zoom into the world of math further to learn about the various types of quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals can be classified into different groups depending on how many parallel sides they contain. A few common types of quadrilaterals are the trapezium, the parallelogram, the rectangle, the rhombus, square, and the kite. A trapezium is a quadrilateral with a pair of opposite sides parallel. Consider the quadrilateral A, B, C, D shown here. It has the opposite sides A, B and C, D parallel to each other. Here's something interesting. The non-parallel pair of sides of a trapezium may be equal or non-equal in length. Let's now see what a parallelogram is. It's a type of quadrilateral with two pairs of opposite sides parallel. In the figure shown here, AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. In a parallelogram, the two pairs of opposite sides are not only parallel but also equal in length. In the figure, side AB is equal to side DC and side AD is equal to side BC. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. In the figure, AO is equal to OC and BO is equal to OD. The diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles.
It's amazing the properties these quadrilaterals have. Like the diagonals of a square intersect at right angles.
Now that's quite a discovery, Snail. And what's more, I didn't need a fruit or a sandwich to make you come up with an intelligent observation like that. So when did you observe that the diagonals of a square intersect at right angles?
I observed when I ate the barfi.
Oh, God. Let's observe more through our virtual world of math. The diagonals of a square are equal in length and bisect each other at right angles. In the diagram, the diagonal AC is equal to the diagonal BD and angle AOB, angle COD, angle BOC and angle AOD are each equal to 90 degrees. Thus, AO is equal to OC and DO is equal to OB. Know what a kite is? Yes, the one flown in the air at the end of a long string. A kite is a quadrilateral with two pairs of equal adjacent sides. The figure shown here is a kite. In the figure, adjacent sides AB and BC are equal in length. Similarly, side AD is equal to side DC in length. The longer diagonal of a kite bisects the other diagonal at right angles. In the figure, longer diagonal BD bisects the other diagonal AC at right angles. Hence, AO is equal to OC. Also, angle AOB is equal to angle BOC, which is equal to angle AOD, which is equal to angle COD, and each one is equal to 90 degrees.
Wow! I enjoy flying kites!
Finally, Snail! Huh! One sport you enjoy at least. See this? This shows that the two pairs of adjacent sides are equal.
But my kite!
Oh, Snail! Being a bit destructive teaches quite a bit, huh? Now there's a bit more interesting stuff. Do you know what the golden quadrilateral is, Snail?
What's that? Is it made up of gold?
Well, Snail, the golden quadrilateral is the largest express highway project in India. It connects the four major metros of India: Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Take a look at this map connecting the four major metro cities of India.
Miss Marks, who started it?
It's the first phase of the National Highways Development Project, that is NHDP, initiated by former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee.
Enlighten me more.
This project consists of building 5,846 kilometers of 4x6 lane express highways. The cost incurred by government on this project is 60,000 crore rupees.
Oh, so I can travel between Delhi to Bombay easily by road.
Sure, you can. Now with that extra bit of information, I'm sure you would like a recap. Here we go. In this module, you have learned that a quadrilateral is a plane figure with four sides and four angles. Sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degrees. A trapezium is a quadrilateral with a pair of opposite sides parallel. A parallelogram is a quadrilateral with two pairs of opposite sides parallel and equal. A rectangle is a parallelogram where all its angles are right angles. A parallelogram having all its sides equal in length is called a rhombus. A square is a rhombus where all its angles are right angles. A kite is a quadrilateral with two pairs of equal adjacent sides.